I'll would go you first.
Okay, I think the last night the last night that we spent together, in high school, because of the uncertainty of everything.
We just walked.
Yeah.
I don't know how to explain it. We just walked that whole night, and it was nice because we were getting to know each other. And funny story, let me add on to that, because we had not we were dating for 5 months at that time, and we had never kissed. So like it was the last day of ever seeing each other, because we didn't know we were still going to continue seeing each other. So it was like, is he going to kiss me? Because this is the last time. Literally we were dating and going out, and we'd never kissed because I was not yet comfortable kissing. And I didn't know how to bring it up that I think you should kiss me because it's the last time we see each other. So yeah.
The day I met her. You know when you see a shooting star for the first time, you know? I'd like to relive that moment again, you know. Because now I'm used to that star, you know. I'm just like, yeah.
Oh, okay. I see.
You know, but I definitely want to relive the day I met her. The very first time I saw her, the very first time she looked at me in my eyes. Yeah. Because right now she would just look at me and be like, yeah. My man.
Yeah, it's just this.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah. Wow.
For me, it definitely wouldn't be the same for her. When she walked down the aisle, I was in tears, guys. She was like, this is a normal day to me.
Oh my gosh.
I was in tears. She was just going on as, you know, it's a normal day. Yeah.
He's dying. He's like, the thing is, I don't cry for happy moments. Like, it's just not me, because I cry a lot for sad moments. So my body associates tears with sadness. So I'm just not going to cry, because they're not cry all the time. But that was a sweet
that moment. And maybe when we got engaged as well. Same reaction. No, it's the same. It's the same kind of moment.
Yeah.
So walking down the aisle.
I feel like you're gonna be surprised at what I'm gonna say.
Yeah.
And so we stayed up the whole night, right? The whole night was Saturday night. He walked me, blah blah blah. And then when we got to when he got to his hostel, I got to where we booked with the girls. Then we showered. Then we went to church because it was Sunday. Literally didn't sleep. Then we went to church. Then after church, we had lunch. And then, I don't know, I felt like, oh my word, this is the last time we're seeing each other. Is he going to kiss me? And then he kissed me.
So it was really... First kiss, it was
first kiss, first time spending such a long period together. Yeah. And just actually just getting, you know, just hanging out. We never really did that because we only saw each other once a week So it was really nice. And it's cool that...
We share the same.
Yeah, it might be a bad kisser. I don't know.
She'll never know. She wouldn't know.
Yeah, so I don't know. I was scared. I didn't know how you do it. I was like, but then, yeah.
The first time I told you I was pregnant, most guys would be like, especially if you are unemployed and you're not financially stable, they'd be really at the edge, oh my gosh, what are we going to do? He wasn't like that. He screamed. He was on his knees. At some point, I think he even cried a bit. And that's with both pregnancies. And it always just, sure, it gives me such a good feeling, assurance to say that, he's going to be here, even if it's not for me, but for our child as well. His reactions are always, I always think about such things. They're so cute. It's so amazing. Yeah.
But Valentine's Day 2020.
Hectic.
One.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was literally one of my favorite days ever.
Yeah.
It doesn't triumph my wedding day and my engagement.
You see.
No, but it doesn't. It doesn't triumph my wedding day and the engagement.
Yeah.
But I remember just thinking, wow, I'm really dating this guy who went through all of this for me. He planned, we actually wanted this other wedding venue, right? But it was 360
67,000 rand for 200 people. So we were like, there's no way we can afford that.
Are you telling people that this guy doesn't make money?
No, okay. We just couldn't afford
it. So people know I can't afford it.
No, man. We just couldn't afford it.
Yeah.
But so what we what he did was that they were having like a Valentine's Day 3-course meal thingy. And he booked it for us, and we literally went, like, from the morning, we had breakfast somewhere, then we went quad biking, then it was like, come back, change, we went for that 3-course meal at this very amazing venue, and like, it was just nice, like, my heart was just so full that day, and yeah, let's hope he tops it on the 14th of Feb 2022. Yeah, no, he has to top it, babe. You have to top it, man. I'm sorry.
You for being there, even on days where I feel like I can't be there for you.